trees and flowers and everything, and it reminds us, because we sometimes forget, just like I forget about the bunny rabbit, we forgot that Jesus rose from the dead, and so we need somebody to remind us. So that's why we come every Sunday. That's why we look at the cross and we see that it's empty, to remember that Jesus rose from the dead. And sometimes things are hard, aren't they? Last Sunday, Ken was reminding us that you don't always get your way. You don't always get what you want. And sometimes you're scared, right? Sometimes you're mad. You guys ever get mad? You ever get sad? You ever wonder what you're going to do? Sometimes. And when those times happen, remember, God raised Jesus from the dead. And if God raised Jesus from the dead, God can help you, and God will help you and be with you through any situation, and it's all going to be okay. Okay, so don't forget. Remember and remember, and you know what? If you come around again, I'll remind you that God raised Jesus from the dead. I hope you all have a very happy Easter, and we're going to pray. I'd like you to pray after me. So I say the words, and then you say the words. Thank you, God, for raising Jesus from the dead. And when we forget, you remind us over and over again. Keep reminding us. We forget. Keep reminding us. Thank you, God. Amen. Thank you. Have a happy Easter. Have a happy Easter. Let us hear these words from the Gospel according to Luke, the 24th chapter, beginning with the first verse. But on the first day of the week, at early dawn, they came. came to the tomb, taking the spices that they had prepared. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they went in, they did not find the body. While they were perplexed about this, suddenly two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you, while he was still in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and be crucified, and on the third day rise again." Then they remembered his words, and returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the other women with them who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb. Stooping and looking in, he saw the linen cloths by themselves. Then he went home, amazed at what had happened. This is the written word of God for all of God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Last weekend, on the day before Palm Sunday, my wife Stephanie asked me what I would be preaching about the next day, to which I answered with the sermon title, "Cheering for the Right Jesus." And she turned to me, and she looked at me, and she said, I think I've heard that one before. Now, I'll grant you, if anybody has the right to say, "I think I've heard that one before," I think she is the one. Though it is rare that I should pull out an old sermon, and this wasn't going to be one of those instances, though I had to confess, as I explained it, I said, "I can understand why you think you've heard that sermon before, because I feel like I always say the same thing on Palm Sunday." Now, I've never heard it said this way before, but I think that maybe one definition of preaching is saying the same thing over and over. That may be as true about Easter preaching as it is about any other kind of preaching, if there is any other kind. Though I never remember re-preaching an old Easter sermon, except one year when I had 4 deaths and 3 funerals during Holy Week. And so on Saturday afternoon, I took 2 old Easter sermons, I put them together, I got really excited about it, and my wife ended up saying, "I haven't heard you preach like that in a long time." Out of all the voices I listened to this week, I will thank 2 of those voices publicly. One of them is Jason Biasi, a preacher and teacher of preachers, who said, "Religious people are, by definition, those who remember." And then the other is the now late and great preacher and teacher of preachers, Fred Craddock, who said that remembering is often the activating of the power of recognition. For this reason alone, it is important that the teacher and the preacher share with the listeners the story of Jesus and of the church. Such recitals may not strike fire at the time or be heard as matters of burning relevance. However, the time will come when the congregation will remember, and it will make all the difference. But one cannot remember what one has not heard. So I am the lucky one who gets to tell you over and over and remind you over and over again. If I've told you once, I've told you 1,000 times, God raised Jesus from the dead. Preacher is the lucky one who gets to keep telling that same story over and over and over again, and who realizes that in spite of all the lilies and all the fancy music and our Easter best and everything we try to do to ramp up the volume on Easter Sunday, this story and alas, this sermon may not do a thing for you today at all. It may fall flat. In fact, the whole thing really isn't finished until it happens to you. until somehow Easter happens to you and you remember the resurrection and you remember the story and you remember that you've heard it, and God only knows when that's going to happen. I don't know. After all, this resurrection business does not make logical, rational, reasonable, scientific sense. And a lot of us are rational, reasonable, logical, scientific people, aren't we? So it's hard to believe. It's just hard to believe this. Let's not pass over that. Paul speaks of it not in theory or as a lofty hope, but as a fact. He says, but in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead. And it seems like a miracle to me that anybody can say that, even a preacher. Just seems like a miracle, because a person doesn't automatically believe all this. That's why she needs somebody to tell her over and over and over again. That's why a preacher needs to keep telling it, because he needs to keep hearing it over and over, ultimately, in order to keep believing it. If the resurrection were easy, if it were perpetually evident and clear all around, we wouldn't need to remember. But it is not. So every Sunday is an Easter Sunday. Every Sunday is a resurrection Sunday. So that we don't forget. It's easy to forget. So easy. It's easy to forget what we already know. And as we said on Monday, Thursday, it is more likely that we will forget than that we will remember. So the two men in dazzling white tell the women at the empty tomb to remember. Remember what he said, don't you remember it? Remember what Jesus told you. Remember how he told you that he would be betrayed into the hand of sinners and crucified, and on the third day he'd rise again. Remember what you've already been told. Just remember it. And it works. It works. This time, it works. That day and that time right there, it works. And that seems a little bit miraculous to me, given how easy it is to remember everything else they've seen and all the other things that they've heard. How he was betrayed and denied and abused and tried and crucified and dead and buried. It's not hard to remember things like that. Hard to forget them, even if you try. No doubt it's easy for Peter to remember what he did to Jesus, what he said about Jesus three times. I don't know him. I don't know him. I don't know him. It's easy to remember, to use Luke's word, the things that perplex us. Like why Jesus was in the tomb and then he's not, and why terrible things that shouldn't happen end up happening anyway, or why things go wrong at just exactly the wrong time, or why God doesn't step in and fix things the way I think they need to be fixed, or why anybody would vote for a certain person, whoever that person is, or how anybody could ever disagree with me, for instance. Those are the things that are hard to forget, perplexing. And that's not to mention how very easy I find it to remember what somebody did to me, or what somebody said to me, or the mistakes that I've made, or the news of the day, and the day, and the day that seems like the day before that, and the day before that, and the day before that, only different people with different names and different places. I remember history class. And the things that we've done, the terrible sufferings that human beings have inflicted on each other. I remember my own troubles and my own problems and my own confusion and my own concerns and my own questions. I can remember those things. And just like those women, just like them, I can remember death. I remember some tombs, some graves of my own, some markers with names of people I love. I can remember them. I can go there And I can see those graves and I can remember, and I'm the kind of person who sometimes likes to do that. I can remember all these things, but I'll tell you this, it's going to take a while to work this resurrection business out. It just is. It's easy to forget. That's why we come to church every Sunday and every Sunday and every Sunday, because it doesn't take a full 7 days to forget. Sometimes it doesn't take 7 seconds to forget. You get out there, 7 seconds, you forgot. You'll remember everything else, but you'll forget Jesus rose from the dead. It's why Jesus will appear again and again and again and again over the course of many days, and for us, several Sundays. Because even the ones who believe right away and say, yes, yes, I believe, they're going to forget. They're going to forget. Next Sunday, he's going to appear to the disciples while they're on lockdown for fear of the authorities. He's going to appear to Thomas because Thomas wasn't there, and he won't believe unless he sees it.